हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर विद्याधर शिवसागर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी लेक्चर नंबर 5 ऑन यूनिट इंट्रोडक्शन टू द ऑटोमेशन, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू बी सी ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन। इन ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन लिंक टुगेदर वेरियस वर्क स्टेशन। ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन मीन्स कैरीज द मटेरियल फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अदर प्लेस। ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन प्लेज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल इन ऑटोमेशन टू मिनिमाइज द लीड टाइम। ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन्स और ऑटोमेटेड मटेरियल हैंडलिंग सिस्टम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू मूव द मटेरियल फ्रॉम वन वर्क स्टेशन टू अनदर वर्क स्टेशन फास्टली इन सच ए वे टू मिनिमाइज द वेस्टेज टाइम इन मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एंड टू इंक्रीज द प्रोडक्टिविटी। सो द इफिशियंसी ऑफ द ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द हाइएस्ट प्रोडक्टिविटी इन इंडस्ट्री। ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन लिंक टुगेदर वेरियस वर्क स्टेशन। ऑटोमेटेड फ्लो लाइन्स आर जनरली द मोस्ट अप्रोप्रिएट मीन ऑफ द प्रोडक्शन। Now, what are the different objectives? As the labor cost is increasing day by day, so the labors are involving for moving the material from one place to another place. So the first objective of implementing the automated flow line in industry is to reduce the labor cost. Then the second objective is to increase production, as when we move the material from one place to another place fastly by without wasting the time or to minimize the lead time, it increase the production and productivity. It reduce work in progress. So in process material where the processing is going on, in this particular automated flow line, using this automated flow line, can reduce the work in process, can minimize distance between two workstations or two operators, and it can be specialized the operations. If it is a mass production, if it is a job production or batch production, that the specification of the automated flow lines will be required, and it ultimately specialize the particular operations for the particular automation types. Okay. Then achieved integration of operation. All the operation in the shop floor or the processes in the shop floor can be integrated with the automated flow line. To transmit the material, to transmit the raw material, to transmit the in-process material and finished product from one place to another place, effectively and efficiently to achieve the highest efficiency and productivity in industry. Now, automated flow line basically divide into two types, inline type and rotary type. Inline type, it consists of the sequence of workstation in omore or less straight in line arrangement, in consist of 90 degree turn or workpiece orientation with the straight line configuration. The mostly in line type of automated flow line are implemented where the workpiece is big, work product is big, and the workstation having the distance is long, and we having a specific or the sufficient availability of the workplace for installing the inline type of automated flow line. Then next is the rotary type of automated flow line. In the work part indexed around the circular table or a dial, in it workstation located around the periphery of the dial of table, or all the machines or the all machine tools are arranged along the circular table, dial shaped table, where the work part is moving from one workstation to another workstation in a rotary manner. This type of automated flow line implement where the space for the shop floor is very less and the work part size is very small. In this condition, that kind of rotary type of automated flow line is suitable. In it, the work part position for the processing is circular periphery each workstation. Now, various method of work part transport: continuous transfer, intermittent transfer, or we call it as asynchronous transfer and asynchronous transfer. So first of all, we are going to be see the continuous type of transfer. In it, work part are moving continuously at constant speed from one workstation to another workstation. In it requires the workstation head having more continuous with the work part. It is easy to construct, achieve high production. The best example is a beverage bottling operation or food packaging operations, in which the material or the product is moving from one workstation to another workstation. In this type of plant layout is a product flow layout, in which the product is moving continuously and along the product moving path, the all workstations are arranged. So the continuous transfer of the product in food processing industry is occurred. And in this condition, the continuous transfer type of automated flow line need to be implemented over there. Now, next is the intermittent or asynchronous transfer. In intermittent or asynchronous synchronous transfer unit workpiece is moving with a intermittent or discontinuous motion. When the workpiece in machining operation comes to one workstation, we need to perform the machining operation. During the machining operation, the rest of all workpiece which is at the backside of the machining workpiece are waiting for the machining operation at the machining workstation. So that is the major disadvantage of that kind of intermittent or synchronous transfer, is that the blocking of the automated flow line for a particular period of time. In it, workstation are fixed and work part is moving between one workstation to another workstation. Work part stop at each workstation for the processing. It is also called as synchronous type of transfer. Best example for it is machining and pressing operation. The extended automated flow line type is a synchronous transfer, in which work part is moving to the workstation when processing on workstation is under process. It called a power or feed system. A different type of transfer mechanism. There are different type of transfer mechanisms are available. Linear transfer mechanism and rotary transfer mechanism. In linear transfer mechanism, walk beam mechanism and powered roller conveyor system. And third is chain drive conveyor system. Now let's see what is a walking beam mechanism. As you can see on the diagram, in it the work part are lifted from one workstation to other workstation by the transfer beam and move from one position ahead in the next station. The transfer bar then lower the pan into the next, which position them more accurately for the processing. So that kind of walking beam mechanism conventionally used in the conventional automated flow line mechanisms, where the powered automated flow line mechanism was not there. So then the powered roller conveyor mechanism was evolved, in which the type of system is generally stock handled system as well as automated flow line. The conveyor can be used to move the pan or pallet process flat raising surfaces. The roller can be powered by either two mechanism. The first is belt drive, in which the flat moves belt beneath the roller provides the rotation of the roller by the friction. And these rolls are powered with the help of some power devices like electrical motors also. Then the last one is a chain drive conveyor system, in which the chain drive conveyor system, the chain conveyors are used, either is a chain or a flexible steel belt is used to transport the work part from one place to another place. Chain drive is pulled either one direction over the under the configuration, which is pulled under the horizontal axis and around the corner of the configuration. It can be used for a continuous, intermittent or asynchronous movement. Then the next type of the automated flow line is the rotary transfer mechanism, in which the three type of mechanism we can use: a rack pinion mechanism, ratchet and pebble mechanism, Geneva mechanism and cap mechanism. Ratchet and pebble mechanism is rack and pinion mechanism is the most famous and popular mechanism used for the rotary conveyor mechanism, where the table is a dial shaped table, circular table, on which the job is moving at the circular manner or the rotary manner. And this mechanism is simple, but it is not considerable specially suited for the high speed operations, often associated with the indexing mechanism, in which a piston is driving the rack and this rack is meshed with the pinion. Due to the moment of the rack, the pinion is moved and the pinion is attached with the dial shape of the table, indexing table, which can be rotated, and due to the rotation of the table, the product is kept on the table, can move from one workstation to another workstation in rotary manner. Then next mechanism is a ratchet and pebble mechanism. It is one of the most popular and effective mechanism which is used for locking purposes for one direction movement of the dial shape or circular table in the automated flow line rotary mechanism. In ratchet and pebble mechanism, devices allowed a linear rotary motion in which one direction, while preventing motion in opposite direction. A ratchet consists of the gear wheel, in which a pivot spring loaded springer called a Powell is engaged the teeth. The spring for the forcing it back with the click into the depression before the next tooth. When the teeth is moving other direction, the angle of the Powell causes in the catch again. The tool stop further and the motion in a particular direction. So the single direction movement ratchet and Powell mechanism is most effective mechanism used for the rotary type of automated flow line mechanism. नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट मैकेनिज्म इज द जिनेवा मैकेनिज्म. तो जिनेवा मैकेनिज्म इज यूज अ कंटिन्यूस रोटरी मैकेनिज्म, द जिनेवा व्हील इज फिट एज यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम. एज द जिनेवा व्हील इज फिट विद द ड्राइवर मेंबर इज हैविंग अ सिक्स स्लॉट फॉर द सिक्स स्टेशन डायल इंडेक्सिंग मशीन विच टर्न्स द ड्राइवर विल कॉजेज द टेबल एडवांस 1/6 ऑफ अ टर्न. सो द जिनेवा मैकेनिज्म इज ऑल्सो इज वन ऑफ द इफेक्टिव रोटरी मैकेनिज्म इज यूज फॉर अ सिंक्रोनस टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिज्म. दैट काइंड ऑफ मैकेनिज्म मोस्टली यूज इन बॉटलिंग प्लांट्स वेयर द बेवरेज बॉटल्स गेट फील्ड विथ लिक्विड. देन द कैम मैकेनिज्म. इन कैम मैकेनिज्म प्रोवाइड प्रोबेबली द मोस्ट एक्यूरेट एंड रिलायबल मेथड फॉर इंडेक्सिंग टेबल. द इंडेक्सिंग टेबल इज माउंटेड ऑन द फॉलोअर एंड द कैम इज प्लेस्ड इनसाइड दैट इंडेक्सिंग टेबल. वेन द कैम इज मूविंग इन अ पर्टिकुलर डायरेक्शन दैट इंडेक्सिंग टेबल मूव्स इन एंटी क्लॉकवाइज और क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, रिवर्स और फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. देर आर हैविंग अ वाइड स्प्रेड यूज ऑफ इंडस्ट्री डिस्पाइट फैक्ट दैट द कॉस्ट इज रिलेटिवली वेरी हाई. दैट कैम टाइप ऑफ मैकेनिज्म इज यूज इन रोटेड having very high maintenance. That's why the cost for that kind of mechanism is very high. The cam can be designed to give variety of velocity and dual mechanism. So it is also one of the popular type of mechanism used for the rotary automated flow line mechanism. So that's all about today's lecture. Thank you very much.